Hey, I thought I'd put out a positive post, giving you guys some hope, and just rather than all the other stuff that we're seeing online these days. Hey, this weekend we were supposed to do a really cool event. It didn't happen. We're going to go up to Green Valley Church and feed the homeless. I'm still going to do that event. It's just going to be postponed until after all this stuff with the coronavirus goes away, hopefully sooner than later. But for those of you who are now working out of your house or at home, you probably got some extra time to maybe clean that closet and see what you have in there. If you can do that, and if you happen to find that you have a big bag of clothes, Amy or myself would love to stop by and pick up your clothes and bring them up to the church. I have about a truckload of stuff right now and would love to bring that up there for you. I wanted to give you guys a cool real estate update. You heard about the Fed cutting interest rates to zero. That's not mortgage rates, but we are seeing mortgage rates still staying very, very low. Locally, we've got an amazing market. Folsom, for example, there are 73 homes on the market today, and that's a super low number. Now, on top of that, pending sale, not to do with the 73 on the market, there's 84 homes pending sale. And that's a good number. What's really crazy about that number is that 50% of those were multiple offer. I mean, that's awesome. That's awesome news for sellers. We held two open houses this weekend where we were trying to be very responsible with the social distancing. We had all the lights on, all the doors open so that nobody had to touch anything. I was doing everything I could, but in that rainy open houses this weekend, we had really high traffic. So real estate wise, we're seeing good things, but I gotta ask you all about the toilet paper. I'm not super concerned about toilet paper. I'm concerned about fruits and vegetables and things we eat. And the great thing is I'm hearing that those things are doing just fine. So it's funny, you go to a grocery store, tons of fruits and vegetables and food, except the things that are non-perishable. So I think the stores are gonna stay open, but you know, we've gotta be as responsible as we can. Another really cool thing is, I was listening to this podcast and I thought this would be a cool podcast to mention to all of you. There's a guy by the name of Dan Buettner. Dan is the guy who wrote The Blue Zones. The Blue Zones are the five areas in the world that have, the happiest and oldest people that live, you know, 100 plus, and the most of them in these groups. So, he's on TED Talks. You can pull him up, a bunch of books on The Blue Zone. But he went over in this podcast, he went over the nine things that stack the deck in favor of your happiness. So I thought I would write them down and then read them to you just to kind of give you all some positivity and some hope. So number one was wake up without an alarm. The happiest people are sleeping between 8 and 9.5 hours a night. Yep, that's a ton. Most people I know are probably more like the 6 to 7 hours, but hey, the fastest kids on my mountain bike team, they're doing that 8 to 9, and if you can do it, I think it's a great idea. Number two was eat a plant-based breakfast. If you eat a big fatty breakfast or a sugar cereal breakfast, you're gonna have less energy throughout the day. Number three, it says have coffee with a friend or lunch with a friend. It said that you wanna engineer 4 to 5 hours of social interaction a day. That's a lot. Now, right now, obviously, that's not something we want to be doing with this time of social distancing. But here's my idea for today. Why don't you call five of your friends or get on FaceTime with five of your friends and say, hey, you know, let's not just put ourselves in isolation and be sitting inside. So what's the next one? Four, volunteer. Well, it's hard to do the volunteering right now as well, but if you're comfortable doing it, great. But if not, you can do things like give me a large bag of clothes and I'll take it to the homeless outreach that Green Valley Church has. So it says worldwide, statistically speaking, volunteers are more happy than non-volunteers. Number five is take a nap. I could do that real easily. Number six, work part-time instead of full-time. Now, this is a hard one where we live, but the numbers show that those of you who work less than 35 hours a week report the highest levels of happiness. Of course, you need to make enough money to live. I get that. And that might not be ideal for you. It's a tough one for me for sure. Number seven is belonging to a faith stacks the deck in favor of happiness. I wholeheartedly believe that. Love my district church. Number eight, watching TV or social media. It says 30 minutes a day provides optimal happiness versus none at all. But here's an interesting thing. After about an hour and a half, your happiness drops off. Drops off a cliff, actually. So right now, you know, that's probably not the case with the coronavirus because everything we're seeing on there is pretty, pretty negative and kind of fearful. So maybe what we do instead is we shut off the social media and go over to, I don't know, pick a bunch of businesses. I know a bunch of people from restaurants to like a physical therapist who their businesses might be, you know, not doing so great right now. But why don't we get out there and help them online? Let's go go to Yelp, go to Google, get on there and give them a positive review. We can do things right now and we should. So get out there and do that. What was the next one? Nine, spend an hour a day exercising. That's a great news right now is we can do that. That could be gardening or walking or getting out on a mountain bike ride. Tomorrow, I'm going with a good friend of mine, Scott Dirksen, to go ride our mountain bikes, 62-mile mountain bike ride. He just turned 62 today, so that's going to get me my hour a day of exercise. So that's the that's what Dan says. Dan's the Blue Zone guy. If you want to watch some great TED Talks, look him up, Dan Buettner, Blue Zones. What else do I got for you? Okay, I'll leave you with a couple of last fun facts. Number one, did you know broccoli has 3 times the vitamin C of an orange? Almost 3 times. Look it up, Google it. And then the last thing, what else do I have? Oh, did you guys know that real men can wear UGG boots? Check these out. Yeah, okay, maybe it doesn't match the jacket and the shirt, but hey, have a great day. Leave some positive comments. Go out and get on FaceTime with a friend, but I love y'all and I'm happy to know you. Thanks.